Telecom Barcelona.
Welcome, COLIBRI students. This presentation aims to introducing the module O11 on advanced in broadband technologies. The outline of this presentation will include first the purpose of this module, then we'll discuss the learning objective we are pursuing, and finally, of course, we will present the course structure, which is basically consisting of an introduction, a basic submodule, and an advanced submodule, like all other modules of the COLIBRI course. If you want to see where the module O11 is placed according to the COLIBRI map, you can see this box highlighted in green, in soft green. So it's there, advanced in broadband technologies, and it's, as you can see, it's in relation, directly related with future internet architectures module, and of course is in the site of the networking profile descriptions. Concerning to the course purpose, what is our purpose in this module is to give an overview of the current and expected future technologies used in the access and in the backbone of the internet. In the access, we have wired and wireless technologies, and in the backbone, usually are usually in all the cases are wired, and in fact, more than wired are optical fiber infrastructure. Also, the purpose of this course is make understandable how these technologies help in fulfilling the requirements of the future internet, which, as you know, is continuously growing and developing. In order to understand these two concepts, access and backbone technologies, it's nice or it's interesting to see the TCP/IP architecture, in other words, the internet architecture, which you can see here. This is a generic picture that can be used to describe many different situations. But in particular, we are going to use this picture for describe what is the access network and what is the backbone network. So here you can see a host A connected to a host B through a router J, which is linking two networks, network 1 and network 2. So in fact, this is the typical architecture of internet, because internet comes from the acronym interconnection network, or it's internet is an acronym of interconnection network. So in fact, internet is not a network, but a network which interconnects other networks. So knowing that this is the generic picture, if we take the host A as the device of the user that wants to access to internet, can be a residential user, can be a business user, can be a big company, whatever. So in any case, you can have from a portable PC to a smartphone, and also to a big network campus, big network or a local area network, or a company private network. This device, let's assume that we are a residential user that we want to access to a web in the internet, in this case host B, and this host B also can be seen as the rest of internet, a set of servers. But in this particular case, we can imagine or figure it out that the host B is the web server where the host A device, handled by the residential end user, wants to reach. So then, in this case, in this situation, network 1 is the access network. The access network means that the network that brings you the connection between the PC at your home and the router at the operator premises. So the router G is the first router you can reach, and from this router you can reach the server through a backbone network. A backbone network which can be belonging of one only a single domain, or can be composed of several domains. But the network 2 is in fact the backbone network. Okay, so I think this is should be clear that the access network is the one that is linking the user device to the telecommunication infrastructure, and in fact the network 2 is the telecommunication infrastructure itself, the backbone network. Okay, so this, we'll come back to these ideas later on when we will describe the introduction, the basic and the advanced some models, but now we want to point out which are the learning objective of this model. So, namely, the learning objectives of this model are, first, when is get a general understanding about the different technologies involved in broadband internet. So broadband internet means that the internet, it's growing and growing, not only in number of users, but also in the capacity that allows the user to access. So that's why it's called broadband. Second one, be able to understand how network technologies constrain network performance. So according to the technology, you will have a performance. And if you want more performance, you will have to enhance this technology. And that's why we came from, for instance, the third cell phone network technology to the fourth and to the fifth mobile technology that you have probably heard about. And finally, we want to you to have knowledge about network evolution from the technical point of view. How this evolution from ordinary technology or networks to broadband and more enhanced and high performance internet it's becoming. About coming back to the course structure, this is divided as we have said at the beginning, with an introduction, which deals with the main definitions and concepts about network transmission, switching, and protocols. If we go more in detail to this introduction, we can see that the main concepts we are going to deal with in this introduction is what is a network, what is a node, what is a link interconnecting several nodes, what is the so-called topology, what are the transmission and switching roles, and how many layers we can identify in the network, and which are the roles of the protocols. Also, we'll have a description of a basic understanding about all these concepts, and after that should be attained after completion this part. So you then, when you go to the different questionnaires and quizzes, we will let you for you to answer. If you have get these concepts, you should be able to answer quite well all these questionnaires. If not, what you have to do is go back to the different material we have provided for you to see or to watch or to study, and go back to them again and try again with the questionnaires. Before the introduction, we have a basic submodule, which includes the technologies used currently in the access as well as in the backbone networks. Current technology means those technologies that are currently deployed and you can probably being used, or the network operator is managing. So in particular, for what concerns to the access networks, we have a set of slides and some videos on XDSL. XDSL is the most known or deployed technology in the south of Europe, so, and also in the north, but mainly in south of the Europe, Mediterranean area, and concerns to the digital subscriber line. HFC means hybrid fiber coaxial. It's the typical infrastructure that was deployed for supporting the cable TV, which is a technology very, very well widely deployed, especially in north of Europe, Scandinavian areas and Germany and so on. Then about Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is the very well-known technology for very reduced limited areas in house. Cellular phone is outhouse technologies for wider reachability. And finally, WiMAX, which is an extension of Wi-Fi for wider areas coverage. So this was this is about access networks, and about the backbone networks, the set of slides we have provided to you describe MPLS, carrier Ethernet, SDH, synchronous digital hierarchy, and WDM networks, which are the current technologies you can find out in the public telecommunication infrastructure that is handled by the network operators of the internet service providers. And finally, we have the advanced submodule, which deals with the technologies that are likely to impact in the network in the near or the in the mid-term future. So these technologies consist of a set of slides focusing, or this submodule consists of a set of slides focusing mainly on the fiber to the home network evolution, and also this concerning to the access, but concerning to the backbone, we mainly focus in the new techniques for enhancing the capacity, for optimizing the capacity available, especially in WDM networks. This is the so-called elastic optical networks, and also the role of the software-defined network in this backbone infrastructure. Software-defined networking has been also tackled in module 07, but from a different point of view. Here we focus on the role that this approach is coping with the optical technologies, the optical networking backbones. Okay, so let's finish about the description of the course here. You have the different materials I have mentioned, so you can go through them, and any questions you can come to us through mail or to any other applications. And let's focus a little bit on the evaluation, which is also an important topic for you, because you have to be evaluated, and you pretend, or you should have enough knowledge or concepts obtained to pass this evaluation. This evaluation will be done in two ways. One is short answer questions, so questionnaires that you have to answer in very clearly and short, so briefly and clear answers, and then some test quizzes that, of course, you have to select the right answers from several questions. So this will be available for you in the Moodle, the teaching tool at the University of Aalborg has been prepared for you. Okay, so with this, I finish this introduction to this module, just reminding you that this has been prepared by the UPC Colibri team, three professors, Josep Soler Paret and myself, Jaume Comellas and José Antonio Lázaro, all of us assigned to the electrical engineering of the UPC, known as Telecom Barcelona, which has this web page where you can find out some more details about the teaching courses we give and the structure of this school. Okay, so I let you with the rest of the material, and we will be in touch in the face-to-face meetings and also in the virtual meetings we will have, so on.
Telecom Barcelona, tu guanyes més.